coming to work is a little tiring.
Work Tuesdays and Thursdays, go to class Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Live like this, you motherfuckers got a roll out.
Like a king cobra, burns in, I let it burn in. It's very touch and go. Sometimes it can be really awesome and quick, and other times it's like hit the pedal to them, I'll find way. Celebrate,
you just need blood and money I make. I don't know, I just said a mouthful, but is there anything that you wanna ask me about?
I did have an acquaintance a few years back who was actually an attorney. And he had a monster commute. He actually lived in Florida and would fly up here. So he worked 4 off 3, so he would fly down for a long weekend and then fly back. So that was a big strain. He actually did that for years, but you know, he had a thriving law practice and didn't want to give it up. So that was a bit nutty, but you know, you do what you got to do. And again, there's trade-offs for everything. I mean,
yeah, it's a trade-off.
It's a trade-off.
He loved living in Florida, and you know, he loved his law practice, so you do what you gotta do. But yeah, that's about the most extreme commute that person I've ever encountered that I knew. You know, I have another friend who actually takes the bus from here every day into New York City, and that's about a two-hour and 15-minute commute. But she takes her laptop and does work on the bus, whatever, so, you know, it's timeless. And, so it's a sacrifice. There's always trade-offs.
Okay. What's your, commute like to work?
Usually in the morning, coming to work, I'm sleeping, I'm knocked out. I got my uncle driving, so we got 5 people that we carpool.
I live in Easton, Pennsylvania, so it's about 45 minutes, depending on if there's traffic or not.
I have somewhat of a privilege of working a crazy off-shift schedule, so I don't have to put up with much traffic. I live in the northern part of New Jersey in a town called West Milford. I work as an emergency medical technician. I work out of a town in New Jersey called Totowa, and again, it's about an hour, but I leave my house about 8 o'clock at night, so at night there's really not too much traffic. And I turn around at 7 a.m., I'm heading back home, so there's really not much of a morning traffic commute. Everybody's going the opposite way, so
I normally start my day around like 5 or 6-ish, and I try not to get on the road any later than 7:30. Hi, I'm Amir Brunson, and I'm an extreme commuter from Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. I do this every single day. And when I have huge spaces between my classes, I just try and find things to do, whether it's homework or just killing time, I guess, you know, going to find lunch, maybe napping in my car. I don't, you know, have the luxury of being on campus anymore, but I'm very determined to get my degree. And it's been particularly challenging this year, or, you know, this semester. I'm trying to juggle with about 6 classes, plus working back at home, trying to wager out how I'm going to stretch days and hours between, you know, school and work, and, you know, then helping out with family, too. I have a nephew that comes and stays with us during the day sometimes because my sister's also a working woman and her husband. So there's a lot of things that, you know, go into being a student commuter. And one of the roughest things that you deal with is weather like this today.
So the weather impacts, especially in the wintertime, you know, snow and the ice and, you know, things of that nature. Bad, I need that Jeep to be able to get around because I need to get around when the wintertime hits.
Oh my goodness, I did not know that it was going to, you know, be the way it was this morning. I come outside, it's slippery, it's slushy, it's icy. My car took forever to start. And swerved a couple times, almost got hit by a couple tractor trailers. I mean, it feels good to say, like, I feel like I accomplished something because I got here, you know, flew out all that. And this was even, you know, with me leaving earlier than I usually do. But, no, I did not expect it to be like this. I thought we might get, like, you know, some light snow. And, you know, I kind of ignored my mom when she said we would probably get, like, you know, a couple inches. I didn't think that it was going to be like falling, like frozen rain, or you know, how it was, you know, back at home. It's a little bit different out here than it was back at home.
To get a more economical car, but then have a horrendous commute in the wintertime. And, you know, in 2002 Jeep Wrangler, which isn't great on gas to begin with, and I had the big old knobby tires, so that also contributes to the non-economical commute that I encounter. I think I'm probably doing about 12 to 15 miles per gallon, which, you know, for your environment, for you environmentalists out there, you're probably shrieking right now.
I mean, like, the car's decent on gas. Toyota was pretty good on gas, but that's another thing, like, you know, that really robbed you, you know, as a college student. You're already trying to hustle to, like, you know, keep your own change, like your own pocket change, or to, like, you know, make things work.
The car we got a Honda right now that's doing like 35 miles per gallon. So we each pay $60 every 2 weeks, so it can be cheaper for gas.
So that's, for me to fill my tank, it's $40.
It adds up, you know?
Somewhere in my mind, on the borderline of the edge and where I walk along.
Listen to music, whatever. A lot of times it's a good time to meditate, especially on the way home if I had a bad shift, if we had a lot of, you know, ugly scenes and so forth that we dealt with the previous night. It's a good opportunity to decompress and, you know, process what had happened. And
it's really tiring, but in some days I really just don't want to do it. Like, if I have a headache or I'm just not feeling well or just have so much on my mind from school, it just stresses me out to think, all right, I get out of work at 6:30 and then I have like 3 hours of homework and I have to shower and I have to eat, and on top of that I have this commute also. But it also kind of, I find it really relaxing to be in the car after school or after work and to have that drive.
Miles away, your signal in the distance, to whom it may concern.
I had worked for about a year and a half at a hospital in Somerville, New Jersey, called Somerset Medical Center, and that commute was about an hour and a half. Then I was working a normal shift, and biggest problem I was encountering there was traffic, but also being an emergency medical technician, I would stop and help at accidents, and there were numerous accidents that I encountered. I was very lucky to have a boss at the time who was understanding, and, you know, Greg, you get there when you get there, really no reins per se. I didn't have to punch in at a particular time or whatever, so that helped with my hour and a half commute.
That's actually, like, always changing, and my job has been very understanding, you know, of that, because they know that I work and, you know, like, up at school, like, I'm trying to work on this degree, and your classes, you know, can, like, fluctuate. You can have times where, like, you know, either the professor may cancel, you can have times where you'll have, like, an assignment due where you need to be on campus with your group, and, you know, that's what I was saying, it also gets difficult because there's people who live on campus, and their time is very different from your time. Like, they have a luxury that you don't in a way.
Hold on, wait a minute. Y'all thought I was finished? When I bought the Aston Martin, y'all thought it was raining?
good, like, you know, character building experience, you know, for the real world when we have to actually, when we have to commute, you know, from, like, a job at a distance, you know, to home every day. I'm definitely learning from it, you know, in that aspect. But sometimes, like, I think that it'd be nice if our advisors or professors, you know, could be understanding to that. Like, not only am I commuting, but I'm also a student with a disability, and I'm still managing to stay on top of my schoolwork as to the best of my ability. And I'm bringing in good grades. I'm one that I'm, you know, a little concerned about, but I'm bringing good grades. And why I'm saying that, I just want them to be understanding and, you know, not to baby us, because I understand we're going into the real world, is because it sometimes it's just, it's impossible. I'll just give you an example. One time, I had a class with a professor who shall remain nameless. I come to class after a long commute, and I'm so happy that I made it, and, like, just missed just a little bit after, you know, the original start time. I was probably all of 4.5 minutes late. I get there. It was a group presentation, but they had not started yet. The professor was explaining things to the class about some upcoming papers or an assignment. She scolds me and tells me how much I've missed in all of 4.5 minutes. And I sat down and, you know, I started taking notes, you know, with the guy who she told me to. Then in comes one of my classmates who lives on this campus, who came significantly later than me, comes in and interrupts the presentation. She just tells him to sit down, and she had just, like, you know, been picking with me the whole time, as if I was the one who just came strolling in from across campus all of 26 minutes late. And the reason why I couldn't understand that is because, knowing that I'm a commuter and that I try to participate as much as I can in class, and when you get nitpicked for something that will be out of your control, you know, when you commute, like, I think they should be more fair than that. You know, I'm sure that a lot of our professors were where we once were, and even if they tell us what to work on, I know that out of all that staff, somebody has been where we were before, and that's probably why they can give us that info, that insight in the first place. So it'd just be nice if they just, like, you know, remember that once in a while.
Just one last comment about the situation overall, commuting challenges in the United States versus Europe. My limited experience in Europe is that the commute is much easier because of the superior infrastructure, trains, buses, and so forth. Just makes commuting, for whatever purpose, for whatever reason, a lot more efficient. So, the United States, in my opinion, is light years behind Europe in that regard.
I'm coming home, I'm coming home. Tell the world I'm coming home. Let the rain wash away all the pain of yesterday. I know my kingdom awaits, and they forgive.